you to the OIS organizers for the opportunity to join you this afternoon and share Abbott's view on the premium IOL category and what we're doing to hopefully continue to expand that in the future. As you can see from the graph here, the premium IOL category is one of the fastest growing categories in surgical ophthalmology. And that's predominantly driven by new technologies that are introduced that have been introduced over the last couple of years throughout the world. And in 2015, MarketScope projected that there'd be a little more than 440,000 premium IOLs that would be implanted and about a 5% compounded growth rate in this category over the next 5 years. And as you heard from Dr. Yu's opening remarks, while this growth is pretty compelling given the growth in cataract surgery in general, the category itself is significantly underpenetrated with less than 15% of the total IOLs implanted in the U.S. Being of premium quality or premium nature. And it's even more compelling when you think that some practices are capable of converting 50 to 70% of their patients to premium IOLs while others aren't. And so what does Abbott believe we need to do to continue to expand and to realize the true potential of the category? Well, the first thing is, as you heard from the previous panel in diagnostics, is to offer solutions that allow doctors to meet the diversity of the patients that walk into their practice each and every day. And it starts with the Tecnis Multifocal family, which provides very high quality vision, 20/25 or better, across the full range of vision from distance to intermediate to near, as well as very unique characteristics, including their depth of focus curves, their optimal reading distances, and their visual disturbance profiles that allows doctors to personalize their choice for each and every patient that walks into their office. You also have to meet patients' needs, and that comes down to enhanced functionality, not just providing outstanding visual acuity, but also meeting the demanding needs of the patients with respect to reducing the amount of dependence or the need for glasses following surgery. And as you can see from the two bars on the right, more than 98% of the patients reported never or sometimes requiring glasses following their surgery, and more than 60% of the patients with the lowest add Tecnis Multifocal, and 3 out of 4 patients with the 3.25 add reported never wearing glasses at all. It also comes down to the quality of vision. As you can see on the graph on the left, that translates into reduced visual disturbances, the ability to perform daily tasks, and that translates into improved patient satisfaction. With more than 90% of the low add Tecnis Multifocal patients with a 2.75 diopter add reporting no visual disturbances with their, or no problems with their night vision, almost 84% with the 3.25 add, and that compares very favorably with the 86% in the monofocal control. So the combination of a full range of vision, excellent quality of vision, and reduced dependence on glasses translates into between 94 and 97% of the patients saying they'd have the same IOL implanted if given the option again. So based upon this high level of patient satisfaction, as you can see in the chart here, it has helped, each one of you has helped to establish Abbott as the market leader globally in presbyopic correcting IOLs since the middle part of last year. But with all these favorable trends, why the problems? And you can see here in the ASCRS survey in 2014, limitations with respect to quality of vision at night, limitations with respect to intermediate vision, and even hitting the target with respect to distance vision continued to present barriers. And that doesn't even include some of the challenges in each individual office with respect to progressing patients through the office, offering these types of solutions, or being able to correct residual refractive error also pose problems. So what is it that AMO is doing? And I'd like to close with this slide. Well, we continue to develop new innovations that'll continue to expand the premium vision and the high quality of vision across near, intermediate, and distance with new technologies. We're also working on new technologies that'll address patient categories that don't even have answers to their vision needs today. More to come on that in the future. We highly believe that partnerships with doctors to develop better training materials and education for this, as well as direct-to-patient awareness programs like we're doing in LASIK to drive the LASIK market as well. And then finally, working with industry and ophthalmology associations, legislators, and standards committees to continue to drive for expanded access to patient-shared billing in the future are keys to realizing the full potential of this category. Thank you very much.